What if the female manager of a high school baseball team read Peter Drucker's management? Yeah, no, that sounds like a terrible idea. But I'm not pitching a story. This is the actual title of an actual light novel published in 2009. But apparently a lot of people liked it because this absurdly long-titled book got really popular in Japanese business circles and was quickly adapted into both an anime series and a live-action movie in mid-2011. I'd give a plot summary, but actually we have this handy-dandy clip ready to go.
Peter Drucker, management の父と呼ばれる経営学の大家。その著書、マネジメントは現代ビジネスマンのバイブルと言われている。これはそのマネジメントを手にした一人の女子高生がごく普通の野球部を夏の甲子園大会に導くまでの物語である。
I don't feel bad about not hitting you with a spoiler warning because A, I hope you don't ever watch this show, and B, this clip isn't a recap, but the introduction to every episode of this show. I am not kidding. This show tells us exactly what's going to happen at the end before it even gets started. I'm not going to say that Moshidora is the worst baseball anime, but only because I haven't seen every baseball anime. It's certainly the worst one I've seen so far, and it doesn't take long to discover why. Our hero, Kawashima Minami, becomes the manager of her high school's baseball team when the former manager and her best friend Yuki enters the hospital with some unspecified illness. In order to make Yuki proud, she looks for a book to help her with her job and settles on Drucker's management. Of course, management has nothing to do with baseball, but business, and the absurdity multiplies when you do a quick Google search and realize Drucker hasn't been relevant in his own country for more than 30 years. But instead of exchanging management for a more relevant book, like a smart person would, Minami cracks it open, studies the lessons, and applies them to the team. And look, I don't want to make it seem like running a baseball team like a business automatically makes an unworthy topic for a show. Sports is big business, and there are worthwhile ideas to explore at the intersection of athletics and commerce. But Moshidora fails because it just doesn't do this. Instead, Moshidora throws out buzzwords lifted from Drucker's book and applies them to baseball in the most obvious ways possible. When Minami challenges herself to identify the quote-unquote customers of high school baseball, she settles upon the players, the fans, the coaches, and just about everybody involved with the sport. She deduces that a solidly run business knows what its customers want, and after a series of interviews with players, coaches, and fans, she concludes that everyone's motivation is victory. So you're telling me that athletes, coaches, and fans want to win? Crazy stuff. But hold on, it gets wackier. Drucker devotes one of his chapters to marketing, and so Minami looks for ways to make the team more marketable. And she does this, hold on, this is wild, by asking other clubs for help. She's a true visionary. And at last, with Drucker's insistence that a healthy company requires constant innovation, she pushes the coach to come up with new strategies to help the team succeed. I'm actually not going to get snarky with this one because it's probably not obvious to the non-baseball fan, but just trust that the coach's seemingly innovative don't bunt ever method has been a popular strategy in all levels of American baseball for the past 15 years. So yeah, the connection between Drucker and baseball falls flat, but not nearly as flat as the characters. Minami feels cribbed from her namesake character in touch, not only with her name and position, but also her instant likability and guaranteed success at anything she tries. And that's all there really is to her. The show attempts to humanize her with a tragic baseball backstory and some cute moments, but both of these cling so tightly to basic tropes that you could use this show as a sample for a half dozen main character archetypes. In a show with such a lifeless main character, you would think that it would take some chances with some of the side characters, but nope. Most of them fall in line to the cold baseball machine, and whenever Yunosuke shows sadness or Asano shows anger, Minami quickly corrects their feelings to maintain the show's mostly emotionless core. Moshidora can't get any of its feelings right. The jokes are humorless, the pathos is forced, and none of these characters feel real or even likable. The only moment I find genuinely moving is when Minami leads a chorus of students to sing Asano's favorite pop song in order to inspire him through a late-inning jam. Is it a coincidence that this is one of the show's few moments that doesn't shove the merits of corporate procedure down your throat? I think not. What offends me most about Moshidora is that it was broadcasted by Japan's public access channel NHK and marketed as an educational program for adults. But what exactly is this show trying to teach? That you can motivate high schoolers with the lessons of a mostly irrelevant American capitalist? That any idea is worth trying as long as it has the backing of big business? That you can turn literally any activity into a lesson about how to maximize profit? While I don't think Moshidora has sinister intentions, I don't think it comes from a good place either. Turning something as innocent as high school baseball into an allegory for corporate procedure reeks of a business over everything mentality that often rots the emotional core of the American and Japanese worker. Too much of our media obsesses over this perceived righteousness of personal gain without examining the collateral damage global capitalism creates for the sake of profit. And in this way, I'm kind of happy that Moshidora is bad. I hope no one ever watches this show, not only because it's bad, but also because it's bad for you. It deifies Peter Drucker instead of acknowledging him as just another business writer who got hot once, and more importantly, as a cog in a machine that causes so much suffering. It sullies baseball as this thing that can be figured out if you play with a white collar instead of a dirty uniform. It takes one of the things I like the most and hammers it with one of the things I like the least, and that it fails spectacularly feels like justice.